Oh, hi guys. I wanted to introduce you to my son.
Papa? Is the class starting yet?
Oh, hi. I'm Mark. I used to be a senior artist at Blizzard Entertainment, and now I teach art for a living. In this week's episode of my world-famous YouTube art school series, I'm going to show you how to draw manga. I've tried to break up the process in 5 levels, based on your experience, with different things to learn and focus on at every level. You can ignore all the other videos that you've seen on drawing manga. This is the only one that matters. Quickly, let's get this class started. Class is in session. Pay attention. Also, pay the class fee of either one like or one sub. I know it's expensive, but it'll be worth it. Trust me. Like I said, today I'll be showing the very scientific steps to manga art mastery. Manga or anime art is really just a style of drawing. It's a recipe. Like most recipes though, unless you have some experience and unless you have some fundamental skills to pull off the recipe, you're going to have a hard time. Right? Imagine you're trying to bake a cake, but you can't even figure out how to turn on the oven. Your cake soup is going to suck big time. So then, this is what we'll start with at level 1. How to operate the oven. Or in art terms, the fundamentals that make drawing manga possible. I'll be mostly focusing on line art here throughout the video, and mainly on the characters. With each level, the difficulty will go up and there will be new things to focus on. The levels are nothing strict, of course, it's mostly just to give you an idea of what you should be focusing on now, and what might help you more later. From all my teaching experience, I've found that going about things in this order will help most people make faster and smoother progress. So I recommend it. Do it! Alright, get your pencil out of your nose and let's get started! Level 1 will be a reality check for most. As I said, there's no drawing manga if you can't draw from reality, from reference. At level 1, you'll want to make sure that you have a somewhat solid set of relevant fundamentals to support the manga style that is essentially just a very stylized version of reality. It's super simplified here for YouTube, but this is the same stuff that I teach my students. Most manga anime characters have believable proportions and anatomy. If you can draw a simple, real-looking person with, you know, your typical human proportions, there's no way in hell that you can draw manga characters. You've heard this before. You need to learn the rules before you can break them. It's true. So, the fundamentals that you'll want to focus on at this stage are gesture, construction, anatomy, and a little bit of basic perspective. There are more fundamentals than that in art, but to draw manga characters, those are the big ones. I have a popular class going over all the art fundamentals in detail, so check it out first if you're not sure what I'm talking about here. Link in the top right corner of the screen and down in the description below. Gesture, construction, anatomy, and perspective. At level 1, you just want to make sure that you know exactly what those are about. Don't need to be good at any, just be aware of them and start practicing each. Always using photo references when you practice. Up until the last level, there'll be a heavy focus on using references. No references, no learning. Anyway, that's level 1. Easy enough. At level 2, keep practicing the stuff from level 1, but we're going to start placing a heavier focus on construction. At this level, it would be a good time to check out another popular class that I made recently on my construction recipes for the human body. Two of them actually, one for female and one for the male body. I go into what I'm doing here a lot more in detail. Link in the top right corner of the screen. When we focus on construction, we're essentially selectively observing our reference. We try to ignore all the details, all the noise, and try to focus on the essentials that make it work, that make it look like a person. We want to learn how to draw simple mannequins in simple poses based on references. Pay attention to the proportions, but don't overcomplicate things. Stay away from action poses for now. Characters standing still should be the focus. That's hard enough. My recipes for drawing characters were great for me, but look at how other artists construct their characters too. That might work better for you. Just make sure that they're professionals though, to avoid picking up some of their own mistakes if you can't tell yet what's technically solid and what isn't. In any case, it should look something like this, roughly speaking. Not much detail, but convincing proportions. Not super stylized like a manga character just yet. Although, feel free to explore those types of proportions too. Have some fun with it. What's the point of art if it's not fun? But I would just focus most of your practice studying real proportions. Oh, and I'm going to plug one more class that I did about drawing simple faces. I think it helps for the next levels we're about to go over. Link in the top right corner. So many classes, wow. All right, we're at level 3 now. Making progress. Exciting times. Now we get to build our visual library. After the fundamentals, come the flavors. I think this level might be more of a transition, maybe less of a level, but basically at this point is a good time to try a lot of different things. See how different manga artists stylize their characters and try copying a lot of that. How they draw the eyes, is it more serious looking like what I personally prefer, or is it more like the cute mangas with super sparkly eyes? Then what else? How do they simplify different noses, different types of mouths? Each artist has its preferences, and it's the combination of all those preferences that make their style unique. Obviously, you don't want to copy anybody. That's not epic. So copy Manny! And I say copying, but it's as much copying as we were copying the photo references in previous levels. At level 3, we just put a heavier emphasis on using other artists as reference. Find the level of stylization that you find most aesthetic for each body part and adopt it. Cherry picking from a slew of different artists. Just like any recipe though, when you get enough practice, you'll start to make slight modifications to fit your taste better. I remember my mom's cooking books were always full of edits. She made all those recipes her own, but only after she had enough cooking experience to know what works and what doesn't, and how far she can bend the recipes before they break. At least I hope so. Here I focused on the heads, but you would do the same for the body. Do you prefer more realistic proportions? I do, so that's what I usually draw. But maybe you prefer the style of mangas or animes like Pokemon, where the limbs are mostly void of features. Study those, draw them in bunch to really internalize what the artists chose to simplify and how much it's stylized compared to the real references that you've been using up until now. Good observation here is key. At this point though, I'd focus on mostly naked characters. That's hard enough. Once again, you don't have to follow any of this to the letter. But good progress comes from incremental increases in difficulty. Don't overwhelm yourself. Level 4. Once you're more comfortable and can get some decent results copying different style choices from the various references that you studied in level 3, now would be a good time to turn on the heat. Start using more challenging references, introducing dynamic poses maybe, learning a bit more about anatomy, including foreshortening in the different references that you study, both from artists and real-life photos. So far, our characters have been mostly static. That was hard enough at the beginning, but now let's try to inject some life into those characters. If you've been focusing on drawing characters from the front, try different angles, introduce facial expressions maybe, take your constructions to the next level. It's a lot harder to draw characters in poses and in perspective. Suddenly, all your proportions will look funky. That's normal. The cool thing about constructing your characters before you go into details is that if it doesn't look good, you know right away. You can make changes and adjustments at the very beginning. What you don't want to do is start from like the head, add a bunch of details, and then move on to the rest of the body, only to find out that none of it is working and having to start again, wasting a lot of time in the process. Anyways, always start with the construction, a naked, simplified mannequin. Make sure that looks right, then move on to the details, the anatomy, the facial features, the clothes, the hair. Oh, and by the way, I have a tutorial on drawing hair, might help. Link down below. And that's level 4. You'll probably be on this level for a while. A few years maybe, no rush. Have fun with the process. At the final level, level 5, it's time to develop your own recipe. You've been studying a lot, looking at a lot of different styles. You know what real proportions look like and have a good idea of how different artists bend reality to achieve their own distinct style. Still though, you've been mostly just copying others, or rather, using them as reference. How about you select how different artists treat the different parts of the body and Frankenstein together a new recipe, taking the nose of one artist, well, not the artist, but the artist's characters, or the way another draws the mouth, how another does the eyes, the ears, etc. Then modify those slightly to make them your own. If I can give maybe a ballpark number, maybe for your manga faces, get something different from at least 5 artists? Enough that the resulting style can't be too similar to anything that exists already. Same idea for the body. You should have pretty good knowledge of anatomy at this point, so are you going to mostly ignore muscles and focus more on the silhouette for a simpler style? Or maybe something that has a lot more anatomy information like what I usually do. There are many ways to simplify each muscles or groups of muscles. What level of stylization do you prefer? Whatever you choose, make a mental note and try repeating those choices moving forward. It's with repetition that any recipe will truly become yours. Become an expert at drawing that particular recipe. That's what all manga artists do. Soon enough, you'll be so comfortable with your recipe that drawing your characters from imagination won't feel so daunting anymore. Once again, comparing it to a real cooking recipe, when you keep baking the same cookies, at some point you're able to ditch the recipe book and execute that recipe by heart. Same with art. Wow, strong rhymes. As you become a master of your own recipe, you'll be able to ditch the references more and more, and that's pretty fun. Just like my drawing here. Unfortunately, it's the end of the class, so we'll have to wait a little while before she puts some clothes on. Check the future updates on my Instagram. I hope the class was helpful. As you see, there's no secrets to drawing manga or anime characters. You build your foundation first, then you stylize. If you don't, I guarantee you things ain't gonna look right. Nobody wants that. Start from the start, pace yourself. Don't overwhelm yourself, but make sure that you have fun along the way. I put all the classes that I referred to in the video description along with a few others that I think are important and related, so check those out next. I highly recommend it. If you've made it this far, congratulations. You win a free brush set! You'll be able to find the brush that I used to sketch this and a bunch of my other favorite brushes in the top right corner of the screen and down in the description. Also, tell your secret lover about my YouTube series. Good things will happen, guaranteed. And be sure to come back next week for another art class because you won't want to miss this. We're finally going to tackle the topic of...
Papa?